Well, here's another thrift store purchase. It's an old organ. This thing weighs probably at least 200-300 pounds. I need the help of three people to get it in the car. So I'm not sure how I'm going to get it out of here single-handedly, but I'll make an attempt. But I don't care about the cabinet. Yeah, that's going to go away. Everything except for the electronics in it. When I peeked in the back, I saw lots of vacuum tubes, including a big power amplifier. So I'm going to pull this thing out of here and see what's in the inside of it. I got the organ out of the car and ripped the back off of it. And here's what I found. A whole bunch of 12AU7s, I guess. 12AU6, I'm sorry, 12AU6. I think those are all the tone tubes. I'll pull those out. Here's a couple of, looks like Alnico speakers in there, 12-inch maybe. And there's what I used to call a Leslie unit, it's a tremolo unit, driven by a motor. It looks like it has a big Jensen loudspeaker as part of that. But here's the thing I really wanted to get, turn it sideways, was this power amp. Looks like it's got a quad pair of 7868 output tubes. And not such a big, I guess that's the output transformer. And there's a power transformer, which looks pretty beefy. So it looks like it might make a good mono block. I'll pull it out of there and see what it needs. Alright, so for future reference, this is a Conn Caprice organ, model 431. I'll probably save that tag. I got the power amp loose. It actually has a power cord that plugged in over here. It looks like it might have some rodent urine stains here and there. I'll have to clean up. There's signs that they were in here. There we go. So, let's see. This plug here kind of goes up. Let's see, somewhat to the speakers and then up into this unit. This plug goes down to the volume control. So volume control here. This one goes up. That may be power. It kind of goes up here to the top of the organ, so not sure yet what that's for. Unplug it and start pulling it apart. I already got the tremolo unit out of it. Alright, I have yanked the power amp out. Nice beefy power supply transformer there. And I was thinking, oh, it's only got one output transformer for four tubes. I wasn't sure how that was, but when I look on the bottom of it, there's another one there. So I'm wondering, and this may be a dual output amplifier, which could possibly mean that I can convert it to stereo use. You know, have one output be right, one output be left, and then just figure out a way to put a balance control in there. And it's got two 12AX7 preamp tubes. I don't know if it's, I'm assuming maybe one half of it's a preamp and the other half is a phase splitter for the push-pull pairs. And then, I don't know what these other tubes are. 0A3, it's a voltage regulator, I think. 6G and 7, I'm not sure. It does seem to have solid-state rectifier in it. So I'll see if I can find a schematic somewhere and see what we can do with this thing. Well, I got everything out of here that I think I'm going to get. So I took the speakers out. There they are, nice Alnico magnets. Speakers are both in good shape, good cones. And remember, I thought this stuff here was all dried up mouse pee. And there's where the amplifier was resting, and there's the mouse nest. So I think that confirms it. So this is a bit of a hazmat situation. Dog is loving the smell of it. What do you think, PETA? Does it smell like mice? Yeah. So I think that's all that I'll need out of it. Maybe I'll get that volume pedal down there and that thing, whatever it is. And I'm not going to save these tone generator chassis. I'm just going to pull the tubes out. So that's what I wanted right there. Well, here's the power amplifier from the Conn organ. Cleaned up as much as I can do right now. Got most of the mouse pee residue off of the chassis. So it's looking pretty good. You can actually read the date codes if you look real closely. Looks like the 34th week of 1964 on the power transformer. And a similar, let's say, the 29th week of 64 on that output transformer. So I did get a schematic. I ordered a full workshop manual here for the Conn organ. The original manual from 64, I assume. And did include a schematic. And in that, I was happy to find that this is a two-channel amplifier. Got one channel here that they call, string and pedal amplifier. You see that goes through split phase type of preamp and phase splitter straight into the power amplifier tubes and then out its own independent output channel to the speaker, independent speaker. Then here's the other channel, pretty much exactly the same thing. It's called flute and pedal amplifier, same components, goes out a different output transformer to a different speaker. Now, the only difference I've seen in these two amplifiers is that one of them on the negative feedback here coming from the output of the transformer. On this one it just goes through a 18K resistor. And on the other amplifier, it goes through 18K resistor plus a capacitor. So I'll probably just take that capacitor out to make these identical so that, you know, one will be my left channel, one will be the right channel. Even has a little volume control right there built in, which I can just repurpose those as both the volume and balance controls. And it has a power transformer here, which is mostly solid state. There's a couple tubes in here. I think those are just for voltage regulation for some of the other circuits in the organ, which I'm not going to be using. It has a couple of different output voltages here, which I won't need either. So I'll probably just leave those tubes in. That's these two right here. And here's the two 12AX7 preamps and phase splitters, and the two power output tubes for the two channels. I'll probably just remove all of these capacitors and then put which capacitors I need in the circuit underneath the chassis and then cover these or use them for switch holes or pilot lights or something like that. So that's the plan so far. Well, the Conn organ amplifier has made the trip back to the Virginia basement electronics workbench. So I've got the equipment here to start taking a look at this thing. So I pulled all the tubes out for transportation back and we broke one of the capacitors. That's okay. I'm going to replace all these. I've already got them on order. And I'll just go ahead and hide them under the chassis. All the tubes tested very good, so I think this organ had very few hours on it, because the tubes were testing like new, despite the fact that it is from 1964, and it looks it with all the rust and stuff on it. As a side benefit, I got a whole bunch of, in fact, 28 of these RCA built, but Conn labeled 12AU7 clear top tubes. Now, this guy's tested like brand new on my mutual transconductance tube tester. And so those guys sell for up to $100, new old stock in a box. But, you know, since those aren't new, they're poles and they're not in a box, so maybe I can get $20 a piece, but it's still not a bad investment for something that I only paid $10 for the whole organ. So what I want to do now is just do a quick test of the basics of the amplifier. I want to make sure that the transformer has good filament voltages, and since this is a solid state power supply, I should be able to see the B plus on these tubes. So let's go ahead and fire this up. I got it connected up to isolation transformer, variac, and a dim bulb tester here. It's at about 112 volts right now, input. So I'll just check these output tubes right here, and pins 4 and 5 is the voltage for the heaters. So if I just take a look at those two, I get, you know, 6.3 on all these. So they're looking good. And then for B plus, just put this on DC, and pin 9 is a plate of all of these output tubes. So by looking at the plate, I want to make sure I'll make sure that the B plus is working and the power supply is working, but also these transformers, since the B plus has to go through the center taps on the transformers, so I'll be able to make sure that they're good. And that's reading 459 on that pair, 459 and 459 on that pair. So I'll show you here on the schematic. So what we just looked at was right here. So down here is where, you know, the transformer is and the solid-state diodes. It looks like it's actually a voltage doubler of some type in there. So that's supposed to put out 450 volts, and on the plate you should see 450, which we saw, what, 459. So it's unloaded, so it's a little higher than what it should be. But you can see how this voltage goes up through the center tap of each output transformer and then feeds the plates. So we know at least the primary on those two transformers is good, in addition to the power supply putting out the right voltage. It's probably got a ripple on it because of the old dried up electrolytic capacitors, but all the expensive stuff looks like it's in good shape. So we'll keep going. The recapping of the old Conn organ amplifier is complete. Here's all the dead ones that I've pulled out. Well, actually none of them are really dead. They're all kind of still worked fairly well, but you know, they're from 64, so they're pretty old. So you can see on the this type of ones that are in here, once I replaced them, I just snapped them off. And then I mounted all of the capacitors underneath here. So I need to cover up those holes, I guess. But I have to say, I've gotten this thing actually working here, just kind of jerry-rigged it, plugging in the old original plug and just wired up. There's my input coming from a streaming source. And there's the output going to a couple of my bench speakers here. And this thing sounds amazing. I am really, really impressed. Just has a sound that, you know, I've never heard a tube amplifier, a tube stereo amplifier before. I've heard many, many solid state amps, and this thing just has a quality to it that's just completely different than anything I've ever heard before. I'll go ahead and turn it on here in a second, and we'll listen to it just a little bit. Now, the only thing I really had to do with this amplifier, I had to make it right to change a few things here. On the feedback, there was a capacitor on one of the negative feedback circuits and not the other one, so I removed that capacitor. And then there was another little capacitor right here, actually a big one, between the two plates of this one stage. So I removed that so it would be identical to the other stage. But after doing that, made the two sides identical and sounding great for a stereo amp. So these two tubes here, they're really just kind of voltage regulators or sources for the rest of the organ. So I really don't need them, but I left them there because this one kind of glows really cool. It's a zero something voltage regulator. So plugging the holes, I guess I'll need to do and figure out how I'm going to route the inputs and output signals and then come up with some kind of volume control. So right now, right down in here, you know, there's a left volume and right volume. And I just take a little screwdriver here to turn it up and down evenly. Let's go ahead and fire this thing up here. Turn on the power. You can see the cool glow that that thing has. So, here it comes. The boogie on a stoned in paradise. Shouldn't talk about it. Shouldn't talk about it. So I'm sure that sound doesn't really come across on YouTube, but it is pretty amazing. So I'm sold on tube amplifiers now. This thing only has about 10 watts per channel from what I've measured so far undistorted, but man, it sounds great. So that'll probably be the end of this section of the video. Maybe I'll do another one where I clean this thing up, put a, it doesn't even have a power switch right now, to mount a power switch and a few other things and clean up the amp to make it look good and be more usable. But I'm very impressed.